I would like to thank you for inviting me to be here. It is my great honor. So I'm surprised suddenly some student contact me and say I should come here to give a talk. It is very pleasantly surprised. And at that time I don't know what to talk about, so I just said the topic, say what I have learned. And then I'm thinking, should I talk about life? But my life is not so special. So I'm lucky that I don't say what I have learned in life or whatever about life. So because I talk after him, so it's good that I choose what I have learned from my Facebook. So basically, this event is just a good event. It gives me opportunity to look back through my Facebook and try to think about things that I have learned, or things about things that I think important. And given that I come from Thailand, right? Maybe first slide, I want to talk about Thailand. So you can see from this post, actually I'm not a good person for you to ask about Thai. I don't even know how to write a letter in Thai. So I have to write a letter to some organization, and then I ask my friends, how to write a letter in Thai, how to address that Thai people. So, and from the context, can you see that? I asked, should I say Mr. first name and last name? And then this girl said, you should say Khun Somchai, not Mr., because he knows you are Thai. So do you understand what's happening? For Thai people, we create another official English for Thai. So if I say Mr. first name and last name, then I'm wrong. I cannot do that. I have to say this word, Khun plus first name, in the official letter. And then another friend confirmed, yeah, because you are Thai, you have to say Khun Somchai. Basically, Khun first name, basically. Not even Mr. last name. It has to be Khun plus first name. So I'm very confused. So I'm not a really bright person. If you want to learn about Thai, probably you have to ask your Thai friend, not me. Then I look through something, and then this is some kind of inspiring, some kind of a picture, right? So you cannot just, this is a wonderful, cute little dog, and you cannot imagine that it comes from that dog. I try to learn something here. So you cannot just look at things from the surface, right? You have to look at the potential of that thing. Wait, what is that? Okay. So you have to look at the potential of that thing. Okay? So you have to look at the potential not only for our other people, right? So how could, for example, you may say, think, okay, what is the potential of that thing or this thing? So should this guy be my good wife or whatever? So you should look also at the potential of yourself, right? So potential of yourself and potential of other people, that is important. So like many others before me, we always say, you can be anything you want. I think that is somewhat true. So if you try hard enough, you can really do what you want. But you have to try really hard. So just to share similar experience, right? If you talk about academic failure, so I'm not really, really good either. So my CGA is much lower than most of you. And after I finish undergrad, I don't do any work for 2 years. But here, at last, I become a professor. So I'm okay. Okay, talk about motivation. This is another post that I taught recently. If you think about riding a bicycle, you have to think that person has to have arms and legs. So this guy, he has one arm and one leg. And he can win the bronze medal in Paralympics. So that is not Olympic, but it's still very impressive. Have one arm and one leg, but can ride a bicycle like this. So, and how about swimming? Swimming, do you think, what do you have to have? You have to have arms, hands, and legs. Let's see this guy. This guy break the world record. He don't have arms. So he don't have arms, but he still break the world record in terms of swimming for Paralympics. So it's very impressive, no arms, but swim the fastest in that London 2012. So there's a lot of inspiring kind of thing that always make me feel like, okay, if we really try to do it, we should be able to achieve what we want. There's so many people before us that can do it, so we can too. And this boy, no feet, but he get to meet Messi and many other people because he has great skill in football. And you start to think now that Professor Ekachai, you spend too much time on Facebook and on internet. And I know, I recognize that. I check internet for nothing much all day. So see that video clip. And actually, my wife also said that. This is my wife. My wife said, Yi Tang, he is my friend, PhD. So at that time, no, I already finished PhD, but that is another guy. He finished PhD. He entered the PhD program the same year, but he finished 1 year faster. And you know why, right? So check internet for nothing. And my wife said, your friend is waiting for your paper. Go to work. So even my wife know that I check too much internet. And my wife said, your friend in the last minute, he didn't really, last 15 minutes, he didn't see you work, your post, because he's working. So you go to work. So my wife is indirectly tell me to earn more money. So let's see how I earn money. So I buy lottery. So this is my New Year post, buy lottery. So happy New Year. Yeah, it was in Taiwan, so I stand in front of that angel. In my wife's hometown, actually. My wife is Taiwanese. And I'm serious about that lottery, right? This is another lottery. So I say, okay, I see some posts by some other people, like, so he won the gold medal. It's like an idiot's dream come true. I recognize that I'm an idiot who also want to buy lottery and want to win. So I say, okay, I hope I become that idiot too. So, but don't tell anyone that I invest in negative NTV. did I tell you I come from finance department? I am not supposed to do this negative NTV project. But my behavior is according to prospect theory, right? So because I buy lottery, it's like a gambling, so I want to take as much risk as possible. So my behavior get explained by someone who won the Nobel Prize, so at least I should be honest. Okay, let's be more serious. If you really want to get rich, so this is another post. So what should you do? Should you focus on what? Definitely not on saving. But I agree with this article. You should focus on potential. Your full potential. You can achieve a lot of things. And even if you achieve half of what you think you can achieve, you're going to earn so much money. Okay? So let's think about it, saving. So if instead of I drink coffee, today I can drink maybe Pepsi or Coca-Cola, I can save maybe 10 Hong Kong dollar per day. If I save 10 Hong Kong dollar per day for 1 year, then I save 3,000 Hong Kong dollar. If I save 10 years, then I can save like 30 something thousand Hong Kong dollar. If I do all those, then I reduce a lot of my happiness. Because I want to drink my coffee, but I sacrifice something and then maybe I cannot focus on my work, I really need my coffee. So even I sacrifice all those, my life doesn't change. 30,000 Hong Kong dollar over 10 year period doesn't change anyone's life. So you should not focus on save money. So like what he said earlier, right? We should just, in the short term, we can just do whatever it is to survive in the short term. Don't think too much about money. Try to maximize our potential for long term. Okay? So that is more important. So Money is important, of course. So money can avoid us to fall into the situation where we will be misery, right? So but money usually cannot really help much in terms of happiness. There's a lot of happiness that cannot be bought by money. Okay, so in terms of saving, of course you should, but you should not focus too much on that. You should focus on maximize your potential. And then I start to work, right? Like my wife said, I have to work. And after she said that in 2012, then now 2013. Now I'm in HKUST. I have to work harder. But I complain a little bit on internet. So like work overload. So this is my send item for half day usually. So and I say work all day. So what can we learn from here? So you should not learn from I complain. You should not complain and show to your boss like you complaining. So the president is here. Maybe I should not show this page. But I have the learning key point for this page. Okay, time management is very important. So the most one of the most important thing for you is time management. You have to manage your time well, and you're going to do well in many other aspects. Okay, so that is a key important thing, time management. And then after I work hard, right? What do my wife do? My wife reward me with this. Okay, you're getting old so fast, too fast now. You have to use your lotion. So work too hard and need lotion, face lotion, and go to find more money. That is what she said. Not she didn't say that, but I think that way. But when she gave this gift to me for my birthday, she gave the combination of this as a gift. Talk about money. So at the end, after you work for so long, you're going to realize that for life, the important thing, many important things is not about money. Okay, money cannot buy a lot of things, like I said earlier. Money can just help you avoid falling into some bad situation. But most of the happy things happen not because of money. Okay, so you may think right now, okay, happiness is like buy very expensive bag or buy a very expensive car, but that is not the kind of happiness that I'm talking about. There are many other kind of happiness that doesn't really need money, and for me, it is even gives me more joy than the kind of happiness that requires money. So this guy, some guy in the Google, he just go to be the ball boy for one day. Because he wants to remind himself about his happy time when he don't have money. Okay, so the guy who has money always wants to remember the day when he doesn't have money. So that is a key. So that is always happening. Okay, let me try to end now. So for me the same, right? My happy time, this is my friend post this picture. The happy time is the time when we don't really have money, we just go enjoy our life. But the thing that is important is that a lot of happy time happen in universities, which is the moment you have now. So you should cherish the moment and enjoy time with your friend as much as possible. Once you look backward, you're going to feel a lot of happiness. Okay. So and this is my happy times recently. And sometimes things a little bit confusing. But this is the last slide now, the last slide, I'm ending here. So sometimes things are a little bit confusing, but I have learned in my life that you have to be a little bit, I start to be a little bit more happy recently and less frustrated at other people. Like, okay, why that guy do that, do this, it makes no sense or whatever. So I was very unhappy when I see someone do something nonsense. But now I feel a little bit better because I always try to understand other people. Okay, try to find a reason why he has to do that. Why this thing is happening. So like this. Why this thing is happening, and I keep thinking. So you have to have the compassion, right? If you have the compassion, maybe you understand. My one potential explanation, we are economists or finance people, we always try to find a story. So one of the story could be that Actually, the cleaning lady has compassion to us. So after we have compassion to her, we understand that she has compassion to us. Maybe the cleaning lady want to clean the men's room, but she afraid that the male, as a male, we feel awkward. And she still wants the two restroom to be available. The only thing to make that happen is to switch, right? Then the guy go to female room and the female go to the guy room and everyone still can use the bathroom. So the last lesson here is that we should be more compassionate and it will bring us more happiness. Thank you.